A daughter of late billionaire and powerful cabinet minister Njenga Karam will be buried in Israel today. Jane Mukui Wahito, who was battling cancer of the bile duct, died in Israel last Wednesday at 7 p.m., according to an advertisement appearing in the obituary pages of a local daily. Mukui will be buried at Bahan Kibbutz. An event to celebrate her life will be held at a later date in Nairobi. A relative, who declined to be named, said Mukui had discussed the matter with immediate family members before her death. She was of the view that she be now buried in Israel to avoid a scenario similar to what happened 2 months ago to her niece in the US, where she died begging for money for treatment. Michelle Karam, 26, a granddaughter of the late Karam, died in the US in September, days after penning a painful appeal for funds from home to treat cancer. Her pleas came against the backdrop of a fierce inheritance battle for her grandfather's wealth in local courts. During one of the sessions, Michelle interrupted lawyers and cried to the presiding judge, saying she was dying of cancer and could not afford medication. The judge directed the trustees of Karam's estate to provide the required funds to meet her medical expenses. Michelle was among the grandchildren Karam had put in his will as beneficiaries of his vast estate, estimated at S.H. 17.8 billion last year. Prior estimates had placed his wealth by the time he died at more than S.H. 100 billion. Mukui's burial expenses in Israel, according to the relative, will cost about S.H. 700,000. Only her two sons and daughter, her brother, sister, a niece and nephew are likely to attend. The relative said the family was unaware she was fighting stage 4 cancer until last month, most likely because she was trying to avoid being seen as desperately begging for funds from her late father's estate. The fifth born in the family and the last born girl to Karam and his first wife Mary Anwariara, she chose Israel for treatment because it is known for treatment of cancer of the bile duct. It was a unanimous decision made by family members, including her children and in-laws, that she be buried in Bahan Kibbutz. This is because 2 months ago, we had a difficult time in ferrying the body of our niece. We don't want to go through that experience again, the family member said. It was such a sorrowful experience to have outsiders to come and bail the family out while our late father's estate was enviable only a few years ago, added the relative. It appears the decision was also arrived at to shorten the grieving period and avoid delays in funeral arrangements, as ferrying the body would take some time. The relative described Mukui, whom the obituary says was married to the late Captain James Kihato Matthew, as a joyful woman with a deep relationship with God.